तोड़कर दीवार कठिनाइयों की, बस तुझको ही पाना है। रास्ते में आए दरिया भी तो हंस के लांघ जाना है। त्याग कर सारे बंधनों को, तेरी ओर मन लगाना है। तुझमें समर्पित कर खुशियों को, दुखों से पार पाना है। अब और न इच्छा कहीं जाने की, बस लाल बहादुर शास्त्री एकेडमी ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ही जाना है। नमस्कार, सर्वप्रथम आप सभी को नेशनल सिविल सर्विसेज डे की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। पिछले 5 वर्षों से प्रत्येक वर्ष 21 अप्रैल को लगातार हमारी संस्था सांगविन वीकर वेलफेयर सोसाइटी और उत्तराखंड हेरिटेज मीडिया द्वारा नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन सिविल सर्विसेज का आयोजन किया जाता रहा है। और इस वर्ष भी हमारे साथ उत्कृष्ट IAS और PCS अफसर जुड़े हैं, जिनका संदेश आप सभी के लिए इस वीडियो में दिया गया है। तो वीडियो को अंत तक जरूर देखिएगा, निश्चित ही इन दिग्गज अफसरों को सुनकर हम सभी का ज्ञानवर्धन अवश्य होगा। और साथ ही समस्त IAS एस्पिरेंट्स के साथ साथ हमारे तमाम युवा वर्ग को भी काफी लाभ पहुंचेगा। दोस्तों, हर साल 21 अप्रैल को सिविल सर्विसेज डे मनाया जाता है। ये दिवस राष्ट्र को समर्पित सिविल सेवकों को राष्ट्र निर्माण में उनके द्वारा दिए जाने वाले योगदान को दर्शाता है। हालांकि क्या आपको पता है कि सिविल सेवा दिवस 21 अप्रैल को ही क्यों मनाया जाता है? नहीं तो आइए बताते हैं। स्वतंत्र भारत के पहले गृह मंत्री सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल ने 21 अप्रैल को ही सिविल सेवकों के पहले बैच को दिल्ली स्थित मेटकाफ हाउस में संबोधित किया था, जिसके बाद से ये दिवस मनाया जाने लगा। उन्होंने अधिकारियों को संबोधित करते हुए सिविल सेवकों को भारत का स्टील फ्रेम कहा था। Moving further, would like to express a few lines about the senior IAS officer serving as the respected Chief Secretary of Government of Uttarakhand, Madam Radha Raturi, who is indeed a woman of dedication, simplicity and intelligence. Her helping nature has earned her admiration and respect from colleagues and subordinates alike. She leads with compassion and wisdom, setting an example for others to follow. Her commitment to public service and her ability to handle complex challenges with grace make her an invaluable asset to the administration of Uttarakhand.
Namaskar. Aaj 21 April, Civil Service Day par, main civil sevaon mein lage hue sabhi adhikariyon ko hardik badhai aur shubhkamnaen dena chahti hu. Aap sab aur hum sab इस मुहिम में लगे हैं कि कैसे हम अपने देश के नागरिकों को बेहतर सेवाएं दें, कैसे हम लोग अंतिम व्यक्ति तक पहुंचें, एक बेहतर समाज में अपना योगदान दें। और आज का दिन बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है, क्योंकि आज हम सब मिलके चिंतन करते हैं कि हम लोग कैसे अपने कार्य को बेहतर बना सकते हैं, अपनी इंटेग्रिटी, पारदर्शिता, मेहनत से हम लोग एक बेहतर देश और एक बेहतर समाज बनाने में अपना पूरा योगदान दे सकते हैं। मैं पुनः आज के दिन सभी को सिविल सर्विस डे की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं देना चाहती हूं। धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मैम, हम सभी आपसे बहुत प्रेरणा लेते हैं। योर लीडरशिप एज द चीफ सेक्रेटरी ऑफ उत्तराखंड has been a source of inspiration to one and all. Your insights and experiences have not only shaped the careers of many young officers, but have also instilled a sense of purpose and commitment. Thank you, Madam, once again for graciously delivering the keynote message on Civil Services Day. Your words of wisdom and encouragement have left a lasting impact. दर्शकों, सिविल सेवा में चयनित होने वाले सत्येंद्र नाथ टैगोर पहले भारतीय थे जो कि एक आईएएस अधिकारी बने थे। वैसे तो सिविल सेवा की नींव वॉरेंट हेस्टिंग्स ने रखी थी, हालांकि बाद में लॉर्ड कॉर्नवालिस ने इसमें कई सुधार किए। उनके द्वारा किए जाने वाले सुधार के बाद कॉर्नवालिस को सिविल सेवा का जनक कहा जाने लगा। कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाते हुए श्री अनिल रतूड़ी जी के बारे में बताना चाहूंगी कि वे सेवानिवृत्त आईपीएस अधिकारी हैं जो उत्तराखंड में प्रख्यात पुलिस महानिदेशक रहे हैं। हमारा सौभाग्य है कि वे भी हमारे इस कार्यक्रम में जुड़े हैं। श्री अनिल रतूड़ी, द डेडिकेटेड ऑनेस्ट एंड पैशनेट आईपीएस ऑफिसर सर्व्ड विद डिस्टिंक्शन एज द डीजीपी ऑफ उत्तराखंड। हिज टेन्योर वाज मार्क्ड बाय हिज अनवेवरिंग कमिटमेंट टू अपहोल्डिंग लॉ एंड ऑर्डर, इंश्योरिंग द सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ उत्तराखंड। बियॉन्ड हिज एग्जेम्पलरी सर्विसेज इन द पुलिस फोर्स, श्री रतूड़ी इज ऑल्सो एन आर्डेंट राइटर, channeling his experiences and insights into compelling narratives. His contributions as an IPS officer have left an indelible impact, reflecting his dedication to duty and his deep-rooted sense of public service.
Namaskar. Aaj Civil Seva Divas ke avsar par sarvpratham Bharat ke sabhi civil sevakon ko evam जो तंत्र में लगे सभी सिविल कर्मी जो जनमानस की सेवा में लगे हुए हैं उनको हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं। आज इस दिवस का महत्व क्या है? आज हम लोग जिस काम में लगे हुए हैं उसके विषय में चिंतन करते हैं और जनमानस की सेवा को और बेहतर कैसे बनाया जाए उस विषय में सोचते हैं। हम लोग जो सिविल सेवा में हैं वो किसी एक साधारण सेवा में नहीं है जहां खाली जीविका कमाने के लिए नौकरी की जाती है, बल्कि एक नैतिक और विधिवत तरीके से अपनी जीविका को कमाने के साधन के अलावा सिविल सेवा एक ऐसा माध्यम है जहां हम गरीब जो कॉमन मैन हैं और देश का जो भविष्य है, जो उसकी नियति है, जो उसका पोटेंशियल है, उसको प्राप्त करने में भी महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाते हैं। ये केवल एक सेवा नहीं बल्कि एक वोकेशन है। आज इस अवसर पर हम चिंतन करें और बेहतर कार्य करें जिसमें जो अंतिम व्यक्ति है समाज का, जो मार्जिनलाइज्ड है सामाजिक आर्थिक दृष्टिकोण से, जो गरीबी की रेखा से नीचे हैं, उनके लिए और बेहतर काम करें और नैतिकता, ईमानदारी, सत्यनिष्ठा, परिश्रम और विधिवत तरीके से अपने कार्य को अंजाम दें, ताकि जैसा मैंने लगभग 3.5 दशक में अनुभव किया है सिविल सेवा में कि हमारे पास ऐसे बहुत से अवसर हैं जहां हम आए हुए व्यक्ति के जो जेन्युइनली उसका कष्ट है, उसके आंसू है, उनको पहुंचने के लिए हमारे पास अवसर मिलता है और उसमें बड़ा आत्मसंतोष प्राप्त होता है। हम निरंतर अपने आप को जो समय के अनुरूप जो चुनौतियां हैं, जो टेक्नोलॉजी है, जो कानून व्यवस्था है, जो नियम कानून हैं, जो अन्य ऐसे विभिन्न संसार में ग्लोबल ऐसे नए ट्रेंड्स आ रहे हैं, उनसे आपको अपने आप को हम लोग अवगत रखें, अपने आप को और बेहतर प्रशिक्षण दें और निरंतर अपने को इस प्रकार पैना बनाएं, सत्यनिष्ठा से और युक्त बनाएं कि हम परिश्रम से और निष्ठा से जनसेवा में आगे आ सकें और एक टीम भावना से लोगों को वो राहत दिलाएं जिससे भारत अपने पोटेंशियल और अपनी नियति पर पहुंच सके। आज इस अवसर पर मैं पुनः सभी भारत के सिविल सेवक, उत्तराखंड के सिविल सेवक और जो समस्त तंत्र में लगे हुए कर्मी हैं उनको और समस्त अन्य बंधुओं को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं देता हूं और आशा करता हूं कि हम शीघ्र भारत को उसकी जो नियति है विकसित बनाएंगे। इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ पुनः आपको नमस्कार।
Thanks a lot, sir, for your benevolent message. Your passion, honesty and commitment have not only made a significant impact in Uttarakhand, but have also inspired many across India. Your transition from serving as the DGP of Uttarakhand to becoming an ardent writer showcases your multifaceted talents and your ability to adapt and excel in various fields. Your contributions, both as a law enforcement officer and as a writer, serve as a true inspiration to all of us. Well, moving further, would like to say that in 2006, the government officially declared April 21 as Civil Services Day, coinciding with the anniversary of Patel's speech. This decision highlighted the government's commitment to acknowledging and celebrating the contributions of civil servants. Moving on, would like to express about the 1980 batch IAS Lady Officer Aradhana Jori Madam, who continues to exude vibrancy and energy till date, and her zest for life is evident in her pursuits as an avid writer, trekker and travel enthusiast. Her passion for exploring new horizons and embracing adventure speaks volumes about her adventurous spirit. Beyond her adventurous pursuits, Madam Jori stands as an epitome of knowledge and wisdom in the civil services community. Her extensive experience, coupled with her insightful perspectives, makes her a valuable asset to the administrative landscape. Her ability to blend her adventurous spirit with her profound knowledge showcases her multifaceted personality, inspiring many to embrace life with enthusiasm and curiosity.
Today is Civil Services Day, when all civil servants reflect where our journey is now, what are individual and collective goals, and where do we go from here. This brings to mind a plaque I saw in Westminster Abbey in London, which commemorated the Indian civil service, which served the country well. And I would say more so, its people-friendly successor, the Indian Administrative Service. The services have been evolving with the changing times, and officers have risen to this task. From being collectors of revenue, or district magistrates who headed the law and order of the district, now the role of district officer or Ziladhikari is more pronounced, which would be being instruments for development and poverty alleviation, for reaching out to the last man in the queue. The challenge is not to be status quoist, but to be agents of change. Another important development is that of technology, which has revolutionized every area, including administration. It is necessary for civil servants to be tech savvy, which is of immeasurable help. Some examples come to mind, one of them being that of drones for law and order situations. We have seen in riots where there are narrow streets and the police cannot enter, but the drones can do the work. Drones can also be used for reaching out with essential supplies during floods or natural calamities in far to reach areas. Similarly, budgeting, taxation, complex modeling for transportation systems, or even poverty alleviation, artificial intelligence, simulations, these are the tools for today. The debate about generalists versus specialists has been going on since time immemorial, and perhaps will go on for a long time. To my mind, specialists are experts in their field, but they don't know that much about other fields. And I worry that there could be a situation of vertical compartmentalization where compartments don't talk to each other. Just like different paints, different colors have to be put together by the artist to make a beautiful picture, or different notes and musical instruments are harmonized by the conductor to create a symphony, not a harmony, not a cacophony, or talented players are put together by the captain to make a winning combination. So too, a civil servant has to be an artist, a conductor, captain, and so many things rolled in one. I do think that our present system of selection for civil servants is adequate. They undergo one of the toughest examinations globally, and the brightest are selected. They are further screened through an interview process for qualities like leadership, integrity, empathy, commitment. The results for this year's civil service examination are just out, and I've been fortunate to meet many of the new recruits. and I find that they are very, very adequate for this stupendous task. My personal journey has been one of learning, growth and satisfaction. I'm often asked the question as to when decided to be an IAS officer. It's such a difficult question because ever since I recall, I wanted to be an IAS officer. I saw my father as a little girl, when I was a little girl, and one of his assignments was district magistrate in Nainital. And during winter tours, for 3 months, we used to live in the forest in tents. And he would listen to all the people, they would flock to him, hear their grievances and help them. Often by lantern light, we didn't have electricity in the forest those days. So that is what I said, this is what I want to do, I want to help people. Fortunately or unfortunately, I was posted as district magistrate in the same district 30 years after him. It was a history of sorts, a father and daughter being the DMs in the same district. And the unfortunate part was, well, the comparisons were always unflattering. My father's shoes were very large to fill. The good part was, I got a lot of love, immense love, a lot of feeling of belonging, and a lot of public contact. There was a lot of learning, there was often a trial by fire. I recall that I got all the experiences that one can get, all the challenges. After 70 years, there were elections, there were law and order challenges, there were the richest of the rich and the poorest of the poor to manage, and most of all, it was a terrorist district. And I was on the hit list of the terrorists. I had to conquer my personal demons because I remember that the very first 3 days I was there, I was petrified. The normal mode of transport being people riding billion on motorcycles with their faces covered with blankets and a weapon in their arms. And I thought any motorcycle that overtook me was going to kill me. So this continued for 3 days, after which I had a conversation with myself. I said, I have two choices. Either I quit and never look myself in the mirror again, or I fight, stay and fight it out. I'm so glad I chose the latter course. I was lucky to work in a sector for 18 years, a sector that was very close to my heart and very important for my people, that of health. I was able to work in the area of implementation, policy making, both at the state and central level of WHO, which was the polio eradication program, we eradicated polio, and heading the largest global US government reproductive health project, that of $325 million. It was intensely satisfying. But of course, it's a mixed bag. I was heading 32 sugar mills in a year of sugar glut. I was the secretary of dairy development in a year of drought. But the challenge is to find innovative solutions for service delivery and out-of-the-box thinking, which is the essence of governance. I cannot complain. Sometimes it was a trial by fire, but the immense joy of actually touching lives, making a difference, and building institutions is something that needs to be experienced. Looking back, I, along with I'm sure many of my service brethren, have a sense of satisfaction at having served my people, my government, and my country well. Lastly, I would like to say that there is a common perception that bureaucrats are dull people. That's really not so. I know bureaucrats who have conquered Everest, who have won medals in the Olympics, who are prize-winning international photographers, and the list goes on. On my own personal front, I've also been able to pursue my passion for preserving our heritage and been able to author 2 books, one on Amali cuisine of my hometown and second on the temples of Uttarakhand, Adi. I wish all my service brethren and all aspiring civil servants all the very best. My greetings on this very special day. Thank you.
Thank you so much, madam, for your benevolent experiences. Madam Jory's dynamic presence and her continuous pursuit of knowledge and adventure definitely serve as an inspiration to all, reminding us to live life to the fullest and never stop exploring. Your passion for exploration, whether it be through writing, trekking or traveling, serves as a reminder to embrace life's adventures with enthusiasm and curiosity. Moving ahead, let us now know what all are the challenges which the IAS officers generally come across, and also know the changes in the bureaucracy. Straight from the pen of respected Madam A. Surya Kumari, IAS Commissioner Fisheries, Government of Andhra Pradesh, where the words are hers and the voice is mine. But before we move on, would like to express a few words for Madam. Madam A. Surya Kumari, an esteemed IAS officer of Andhra Pradesh, stands out as one of the most popular, sincere and dedicated civil servants in the state. Her commitment to the public service and her unwavering dedication to improving the lives of the people she serves are truly commendable. Beyond her professional achievements, Madam Surya Kumari is known for her pure soul and humble nature. Her humility and down-to-earth demeanor have endeared her to colleagues, subordinates, and the public alike. Despite her accomplishments, she remains grounded, always prioritizing the needs of the community and striving to make a positive impact. Her genuine compassion and sincere efforts have earned her respect and admiration, making her a role model for many aspiring civil servants. Madam Surya Kumari's exemplary character and selfless service truly embody the spirit of public service, inspiring others to follow in her footsteps. Hi everyone, like everyone else, I wouldn't say I have come into the service with a motto to serve people. But yes, I did, with a different goal. I came into service to make a name for myself, to prove my worth. I belong to a middle-class family, and my mother always believed so much in me that she always wanted my sister and me to get education at par with my brother. Whenever I got a rank in my class or any prize in co-curricular activities, she felt proud and happy as she has received it herself. In a way, it was her encouragement which made me move towards the present path. But soon I realized that it is not a bed of roses. First posting was a tribal division where there were many villages without power, road or communication with the rest of the world. Being new to job and away from the family was getting used to the lifestyle with a great difficulty. It needs perseverance and a self-motivation to keep your spirits up. While all your friends moved to bigger cities in pursuit of their life paths, definitely you feel if the choice of yours is the right one. Hence, my dear ones, please be aware that Bobodom is not just vehicles with government label, but you are hope for many while you are a candle yourself, and keep up really finding happiness in what you get to deliver for the masses, especially for those who don't even know what to ask for. The field postings are at the cutting edge level and are most exciting part of the career, though you don't realize it at that point of time, as you only complain of the long walks you take up to reach inaccessible villages or sleepless nights you spend reading voluminous files to understand an issue or struggle to solve basic life amenities provisions to the masses, though many a times are futile and leave us desperate and depressed. Biggest challenge in the career of an IAS is finding time for yourself. Though craving is not in the beginning, but after putting in a service of 20 to 25 years, certainly you realize responsibilities never end and you can't take an off as per your plans, as some emergency on the other will creep in. It is said that no career encompasses all priorities in life, be it money in the form of remuneration, your satisfaction, time spared for ourselves, job security, adventure, and vulnerability. I often ponder when I entered service in 1996, it was much respectable. Though autocratic, was able to plan my day at ease and chalk out my priorities, whether housing, land disputes, livelihoods, health, literacy in my division. Working with political bosses wasn't that distressful at all. Budgets were scanty, but spending was meaningful, and we were concentrating on community pooling and best usage of each pie, always encouraged freedom in decisions as they delegated and observed us perform. But now every minute monitored kind of feeling lingers due to WhatsApp, Telegram, VCs, leave alone calls. There is nothing left to discretion, as everything is computerized. You can see a situation which is real but can't respond, as they don't possess
some documents. Somewhere the authority has been taken over by accountability. It's good in a way, but it robbed the human face of solution. Working with political bosses has become difficult as the treatment lagged respect. RTI, freedom of press, petitions filed, court cases, all these have made accountability so heavy that working has become stressfully mindful. It's not about doing right, but doing visibly right and documenting it right has become very, very important. The respect which was priority for selection of career is marred due to some corrupt officers who tainted the cadre as a whole. The rat race for postings, attributing some posts to be more attractive, lucrative than others by own colleagues, and trying to hang on to them have made many wrong practices enter in. Gradually, you end up doing everything as per the rule book in order to save your skin for future, whether the goal of public is met or not. If you go out of way, intentions are questioned. Having said that, the questionable deeds of a few for their own selfish goals are overlooked. But why? Remains to linger in the mind. Only advice to the younger genera, please take up civil services if packages are not a priority. You can make yourselves happy wherever you are. If you can, show patience and find happiness in the fortune of poorest of poor. If and when you can do something, no matter how small, a gesture to touch their lives. You may take up civil services if you are smart enough to answer to those who try to trample you. If you are mature enough to deal with crisis without getting crumpled. Wish you all the best to all the young IAS aspirants out there. Good luck and take care.
Thank you, Madam Ms. Surya Kumari, for your unmatched experience sharing. Now, moving further, let me express a few words about Dr. Sanjeev Bhatt Joshi, who is an esteemed IPS officer whose dedication and commitment to public service has made a significant impact on the community and have inspired countless individuals, especially the young aspirants.
Namaskar for tomorrow Civil Service Day. Warm greetings to all. I am Dr. Sanjeev Bhatt Joshi, an IPS officer, DGP, and now Chairman Managing Director in the sector of housing and constructions. Long career in the civil service. Civil service is one of the promising delivery of service to a system, to public and citizens of India. And I really wish that in our Indian bureaucracy, Indian civil service system, two, three things must be important, very important, and to be remembered always while meeting a common man. First thing is that free access to all people, whoever comes to meet you in an office especially, and there should not be any barrier, artificial barrier or physical barrier or whatever way. The free access, anybody can come and meet, you know, for the representation, grievances or whatever. Secondly, the integrity and corruption free, that's one of the prime paramount. Other India is very badly, the system is reputed and badly reputed for corruption. And then that's, we are responsible, civil servants are primarily responsible for this notoriety, and must remove this corruption, and we should uphold highest level integrity in our, and in the financial matter. Thirdly, one thing is that they always aim for the most downtrodden and bottom of the jantu. Those people should be first to serve rather than rich and influential. We really forget, we do the reverse, rich and influence first and the most downtrodden the last. That's one of the problem, especially in the tribal community or very the backward, people in villages, all those things. That should be first priority. We cannot say that it is our convenience, but it should be their demand, convenience, and their necessity for service. That's an important thing. I really wonderful and really wish that many young people imbibe ideology to improve our Indian system, and really India will also become very important for whole world to understand our bureaucracy. Thank you very much. Once again, warm greetings to you all.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev Bhatt Joshi, for your benevolent address. As a role model and mentor, your message resonates deeply with young aspirants
who aspire to make a difference in the society. Your insights, wisdom, and experiences offer valuable guidance and inspiration to those navigating the path towards civil services. Your message emphasizes the importance of integrity, perseverance, and service above self, encouraging young aspirants to strive for excellence and contribute positively to the society.
And as we conclude this special episode celebrating National Civil Services Day 2024, it is evident that our viewers have gained invaluable insights from the experiences and viewpoints shared by our esteemed officers. The stories of dedication, resilience, and commitment to public service serve as a beacon of inspiration for young minds aspiring to join the civil services. So friends, we hope that the wisdom imparted by these accomplished officers will nurture and foster the careers of the next generation of civil servants. May their journeys inspire the youth to be strong, courageous, and compassionate in their pursuit of serving the nation. On this occasion, let us reaffirm our commitment to upholding the values of integrity, accountability, and excellence in public service. Together, we can strive to build a brighter future for our country, guided by the lessons learned from those who have led by example. Thank you for joining us in celebrating the spirit of the National Civil Services Day 2024, and let us continue to inspire and uplift each other in our collective journey towards progress and development. और अंत में कहना चाहूँगी, सफर में मुश्किलें आएं तो हिम्मत और बढ़ती है। सफर में मुश्किलें आएं तो हिम्मत और बढ़ती है। अगर कोई रास्ता रोके तो जरूरत और बढ़ती है। अगर बिकने पर आ जाओ तो घट जाता है दम अक्सर। ना बिकने का इरादा हो तो कीमत और बढ़ती है। नमस्कार।